This is the brand new Canon R7 RF-S3.9mm F3.5 STM Dual Fisheye lens. If you are new to VR or immersive monitoring spatial video on Apple Vision Pro, this could be an affordable, great entry-level lens for you. In this first look video, we'll go over the spec, compare it to my Canon R5C right here with the old Dual Fisheye lens in raw fisheye format. And in the next video, we will compare that in VR 180 in immersive format on Meta Quest 3 or Apple Vision Pro. Let's go. The RF-S 3.9mm F3.5 STM Dual Fisheye lens here is designed for the Canon APS-C sensor camera. Our viewer already asked, can this lens work with the Canon R5 or R5C full frame camera? The answer sadly is no. It will fit my R5C as you see right here, but the dual fisheye lens only sit in the middle of my frame instead of using my full sensor resolution. So it will still only be 4K instead of 8K. At the time of recording, it will only work with the Canon R7 right here. Canon said the current setup with R7 allowed this dual fisheye lens to shoot up to 4K 30 frames per second. But I'm able to shoot 4K 60 frames per second on the R7 without a problem, as you can see right here. So hopefully, Canon will officially support 4K 60 frames per second at the software level as well. 60 frames per second generally give a better viewing experience inside an HMD. The RF-S 3.9mm is smaller and lighter than the RF 5.2mm. Here is the weight comparison. When paired with the R7, this VR setup is way smaller and lighter than my Canon R5C, which is great for travel. I can tell you from first-hand experience, traveling with the R5C setup with full-on gimbal is no fun. The biggest improvement is autofocus. As you see here, a hard press of the shutter button will autofocus on the subject within the image circle of the left lens. It does not have continued autofocus like subject tracking autofocus during filming, so it will only focus on one plane when recording. But it is still a great improvement compared to the old full manual dual fisheye lens right here. Adjusting left and right lens focus differences is a lot easier now with this adjust button right here. No more screwdriver is needed. The IPD is 60mm, just like the old one right here, but it will only cover 144 degrees instead of 190 degrees field of view. The logic from Canon of a smaller FOV is to cut out tripod legs and the left and right lens in frame. Well, let's compare it to the old dual fisheye lens to see how much information is being cut out. As you see here, the tripod leg and the lens are gone, which is great, but it is missing lots of information on the left and right sides, which is not ideal. I am out of frame way sooner in the new dual fisheye lens, which reduced the immersive experience. In my humble opinion, if you are coming from a 3D 360 world, you'll be even more disappointed with this further reduction of the field of view. The center of the lens though, it is sharper than the old dual fisheye lens. Another improved design I love is the support of 30.5mm screw-on filters at the rear of the lens right here. ND filter has been a missing element in immersive filmmaking, and I'm so happy to know Canon addressed it in this new design. The official Canon screw-on filter will be my next investment. The lens also has Canon Spatial Air Sphere Coding ASC to reduce ghosting, chromatic aberration, and even color in challenging lighting situations. I was not able to see the differences just yet, so I will do more testing in the following in-depth review. This lens also does not have image stabilization. You can use the EOS VR utility to do pose stabilization, but I highly recommend putting your camera on a tripod or at least on a gimbal to keep it as stable as possible with only forward and backward movement. Canon's official commercial show handheld movement of the camera. Please never ever do that in VR. For professional VR filmmaking, the biggest downside has to be the resolution. 4K per eye and 8K in total resolution are now considered not enough for Apple Vision Pro. The new Blackmagic Design URSA Cine Immersive Camera feature 8K per eye, 16K total resolution for Apple Vision Pro right here. Just to give you a perspective, this lens on an APS-C camera like the R7 only gives you 2K per eye and 4K in total resolution. Let's compare side by side right now. Left, we have RF-S 3.9mm and right, we have the RF 5.3mm, both in C-Log3, F5.6 and ISO 800. We see 8K has a lot more details than 4K. Zoom in on the chart and you can clearly see the differences in image quality. This is just my first look at the Canon new Dual Fisheye lens. We will have more in-depth review coming up very soon. You cannot review a VR lens with a regular 2D video. So in the next video here, I will show you what it really looked like in VR on Meta Quest 3 or on Apple Vision Pro with downloadable sample footage in both MVHDVC and SBS format. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new here, and I will see you next time.